Rekoh, imali pitanje?
Ja ne govorim planinskim jezikom.
Kojim jezikom ti govoriš? A?
Kojim jezikom ti govori tupe?
Ili kojim jezikom ti govori bulja?
Polako, momci, ova žena ništa nije uradila protiv zakonika. Polako.
Ali gospodine, zar vi stvarno mislite da su svi ovi ljudi bezgrešni?
Ne. Ja to nisam.
Ovo je puna greha. Vidi kako je radi bulja.
Gde? Kako se zoveš?
Da gledaš, pre!
Ime?
Ja se zovem Sanja Matejić i hoću da odem odavde!
Gospođo, molim vas vašu ličnu kartu. Sanja Matejić.
Meni liči na neku intelektualnu kurvu.
Jeste kurva. To je intelektualna!
I to sa intelektualna bulja!
A, intelektualna bulja, najbolje ljulje!
Kažu da imaš dobro dupe, a? Ajde, vodi to! Vodi!
Daj, ne! Daj vam!
Vodi to! Stani! Stani! Da, molim! Razumem. Razumem, ali... Da, jasno. Razumem, gospodine pukovniče! Pusti. Ajde, vodi to unutra.
Ajde, idemo, ajde!
Ajde!
Ajde, kreći se, ajde, 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 ajde!
The only opportunity you will ever have. And this is the reason why you should stay here with me in this magnificent and almost perfect environment. Because West is the best. I do apologize for any inconvenience that this refurbishment of our VIP lounge may have caused you. If you encounter any unpleasant or disturbing sound, sight, and vision, please bear in mind that we are doing everything we can to make this VIP lounge the most perfect and the most enjoyable living environment. Future looks bright, future is with us. And now, let's play some games. I don't see you, Lalo. And now, let's have some duty-free shop sweets. Izvolite. Izvolite, gospođice. Uzmite. Za vas. Izvolite. Gospodine. Izvolite. Our juicy and exquisite lollipops. You're very welcome, sir. Please, take some more. Here we go. Some lollipops for you, so we can play some games. Here you go. More, please, take some lollipops. Everyone. I'll have one as well, actually. Hello there. Take some lollipops. There you go. That's all for you. Please, lollipops. Everyone, everyone. Izvolite, molim vas. Izvolite. Evo još par je ostalo. Izvolite, evo ima pa pozadite, vidi pa nemaju. Izvolite, izvolite, pa evo. Pa mislim, uzimaju preko reda, evo izvolite, izvolite. Evo još jedna ostala, još jedna izvolite ostala. Oh, sir, please, for you one. I can't miss you. Well, exactly. So, there is no more. Now, I'm going to show you the art of... I didn't say you can do that. Stop right now. No. Not allowed yet. So now, I'm going to demonstrate the art of how to use a lollipop. Everyone, unwrap the paper. Nicely, very nice, just like I do. Everyone, whoever has the lollipop, very nice. Ooh, just like that. Okay, so, come on, quickly now. We need to have some more fun. And, excellent. So, put the lollipop in front of you. Good, yes, everyone. Well done. And sit. Pominište. Dragane, hajde se. In front of you. Mm. Oh, that smells beautiful. Aha. And now, let's put the lollipop in our mouth. But very slowly. Very well done. Please take a photo of this beautiful young lady there. She's doing very well. And again. And now, faster. Are you not playing the game or what? Come on. Again. Well done, everyone! Well done! Bravo! Yay! Well, you have learned the art of how to use a lollipop!
Stop! Who is that? As a citizen, I must ask.
But especially over the brand.
What is true?
He's got the right attitude.
What is false?
What's the point in doing that? I just don't see what there is to be gained.
Truth in drama is forever elusive. You never quite find it. But the search for it is compulsive.
What's the point of it?
The search is clearly what drives the endeavor.
What on earth's the matter with you?
The search is your task.
It's just a game, that's all. We're playing a game.
An avid cricket film production.
I think it's an American game. What have you done with the scissors?
Can just play some right serious ones. ones that are hard on your bum.
That is what they said. That is what they did. Dark. A woman unable to escape the doom that seemed to belong only to others. But as they died, she must die too. Our beginnings never know our ends. The author's position is an odd one.
What do you mean?
In a sense, he is not welcomed by the characters.
Have a custard tart.
The characters resist him. They are not easy to live with. They are impossible to define.
You know what you are.
You know what you are.
You're an infection.
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 Who are they talking about? You? Me? Joe Doakes? China? Paris? Who knows? You certainly can't dictate to them.
Why? You're getting tired of a life of crime?
The characters must be allowed to breathe their own air.
I honestly think you're marvellous.
The author cannot confine or constrict them to satisfy his own taste or disposition or prejudice.
It's a mug's game. I've told you before. It's got to come from the heart. You're a terrible forger.
Harold Pinter is a playwright who has said some unkind things about the American Empire.
The majority of politicians, on the evidence available to us, are interested not in truth.
What do you mean?
But in power. And in the maintenance of that power.
What are you saying?
To maintain that power, it is essential that people remain in ignorance. That they live in ignorance of the truth. Even the truth of their own lives.
Perhaps things will improve.
What surrounds us, therefore, is a vast tapestry of lies upon which we feed. The truth is something entirely different.
What truth?
The justification for the invasion of Iraq was that Saddam Hussein possessed a highly dangerous body of weapons of mass destruction.
Oh, not again,
some of which could be
surely.
45 minutes,
I thought we'd left all that
about
behind.
Appalling
surely we
devastation.
Have.
We were assured that was true.
You a foreigner? Born and bred in the British Isles?
It was not true.
Oh, surely the wound heals when you know the truth, doesn't it? I mean, when the truth is verified. I would have thought it did.
We were told that Iraq had a relationship with Al-Qaeda.
You're a bloody imposter, mate.
And shared responsibility for the atrocity in New York of September 11th, 2001. We were assured that this was true.
That's the truth.
What's there left to think about? It's a thing regretted, never to be repeated, no past, no future. Do you see what I mean?
It was not true.
It can't be corroded by a trivial thing like this. I've apologized. She's apologized. Honestly, what more can you want?
It was not true.
Do you think I'm deaf?
It was not true.
What a strange man you are, aren't you? You're really strange. Ever since you came into this house, there's been nothing but trouble. Honest. I can take nothing you say at face value. Every word you speak is open to any number of different interpretations. But most of what you say is lies. You're violent, you're erratic, you're just completely unpredictable. You're nothing else but a wild animal when you come down to it.
We were told that Iraq threatened the security of the world.
Don't overstep the mark, son.
We were assured it was true.
Now don't get perky, son. Don't get perky. Stop telling me all these fibs.
It was not true.
You stink. You don't belong in a nice place like this.
The invasion of Iraq was a bandit act.
What are you talking about?
An act of blatant state
Stop
terrorism.
It. What's the matter? matter with you? What's happened to you?
Demonstrating absolute contempt for the concept of international law.
Please. Please. What are you doing? Playing a game?
Direct invasion of a sovereign state has never, in fact, been America's favorite method. In the main, it has preferred what it has described as low-intensity conflict. Low-intensity conflict means that thousands of people die, but slower than if you dropped a bomb on them in one fell swoop. It means that you infect the heart of the country, that you establish a malignant growth and watch the gangrene bloom. The tragedy of Nicaragua was a highly significant case. I choose to offer it here as a potent example of America's view of its role in the world, both then and now.
It has to be said.
Excuse me.
Oh, of course.
Thank you.
Oh, absolutely. There will be a brisk wind, but it will die out by midnight. Nothing further will happen. Well, this is your last weather forecast. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your plane is going to be ready soon. And we'll be proceeding to this gate. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes, we're ready.
Let me tell you something. In war, innocent people always suffer. Innocent people, indeed, always suffer. But in this case, innocent people were the victims of a gruesome atrocity subsidized by your government, one among many. Is your government not, therefore, guilty of supporting acts of murder and destruction upon the citizens of a sovereign state? The United States supported the brutal Somoza dictatorship in Nicaragua for over 40 years. The Nicaraguan people, led by the Sandinistas, overthrew this regime in 1979, a breathtaking popular revolution. The Sandinistas weren't perfect. They possessed their fair share of arrogance, and their political philosophy contained a number of contradictory elements. But they were intelligent, rational and civilized. They set out to establish a stable, decent, pluralistic society. The death penalty was abolished. Hundreds of thousands of poverty-stricken peasants were brought back from the dead. President Reagan commonly described Nicaragua as a totalitarian dungeon. The totalitarian dungeons were actually next door, in El Salvador and Guatemala. The United States had brought down the democratically elected government of Guatemala in 1954, and it is estimated that over 200,000 people had been victims of successive military dictatorships. It is estimated that 75,000 people died. Why were they killed? They were killed because they believed a better life was possible and should be achieved. That belief immediately qualified them as communists. Poverty, disease, degradation, and death. Business. Big business. Big business returned to the vengeance. Democracy had prevailed. The United States supported, and in many cases engendered, every right-wing military dictatorship in the world after the end of the Second World War. I refer to Indonesia, Greece, Uruguay, Brazil, Paraguay, Haiti, Turkey, the Philippines, Guatemala, El Salvador, and of course, Chile.
Freedom.
Freedom is,
I suppose, everything and nothing.
It's a word that you can't, it's not real. Freedom is...
Wouldn't you like to know?
This is difficult. Freedom is...
That's actually quite a personal question, I think.
It's in the mind, I think. If you're free in the mind, then you're truly free. If you're not, then you'll never be free.
Well,
I'm privileged enough to come from what I would describe as free. I live in a free society.
The pathetic and supine Great Britain. And one morning, all that was burning.
Getting a holiday soon.
One morning, the bonfires leapt out of the earth.
Going to Spain.
Devouring human beings.
Lucky woman.
And from then on, fire.
Spain.
Gunpowder from then on.
Lucky woman.
And from then on, blood.
Spain is wonderful this time of year.
Bandits with planes and moors.
Any time of the year, really.
Bandits with finger rings and duchesses.
Spain is wonderful.
Bandits with black friars spattering blessings came through the sky to kill children.
Spain is wonderful this time of year.
And the blood of children ran through the streets without fuss, like children's blood. Jackals that the jackals would despise. Stones, dry thistle, would bite on and spit out. Vipers that the vipers would abominate. Face to face with you, I have seen the blood of Spain tower like a tide to drown you in one wave of pride and knives. And you will ask,
what sun lotion do you use?
Why doesn't his poetry speak of dreams and leaves? Look at broken Spain. Come and see the blood in the streets. Come and see the blood in the streets. Come and see the blood in the streets.
Be nice to get away to Spain.
We have brought torture, cluster bombs, depleted uranium, innumerable acts of random murder. Misery. Degradation and death to the Iraqi people, and call it bringing freedom and democracy to the Middle East. The crimes of the United States have been systematic, constant, vicious, remorseless, but very few people have actually talked about them. You have to hand it to America. It has exercised a quite clinical manipulation of power worldwide, while masquerading as a force for universal good.
Don't speak to me like that. How dare you speak to me like that? I'll knock your teeth out.
The words American people provide a truly voluptuous cushion of reassurance. How many people do you have to kill before you qualify to be described as a mass murderer and a war criminal? 100,000. You don't need to think. More than enough, I would thought.
Live and then live. Less more.
Just lie back on the cushion.
Although the political side of Pinter, I've never been so sure about.
He confirms stupid, sordid little stories just to amuse himself, while everyone else has to run round in little circles to get to the root of the matter.
Pinter is a playwright who has said some unkind things about the American Empire.
All he can do is sit and suck his bloody hand and decompose like the filthy, putrid slum slug that he is.
The United States is, without doubt, the greatest show on the road. As a salesman, it is out on its own, and its most saleable commodity is self-love. It's a winner. It's a scintillating strategy. Language is actually employed to keep thought at bay. This does not apply, of course, to the 40 million people living below the poverty line and the 2 million men and women imprisoned in the vast gulag of prisons which extends across the United States. Look at Guantanamo Bay. This criminal outrage is being committed by a country which declares itself to be the leader of the free world. They are being consigned to a no man's land, from which indeed they may never return.
Freedom to me is not only free of mind, it's
not being in a cage,
but you're free to decide what's right under a structure.
What has the British Foreign Secretary said about this? What has the British Prime Minister said about this? We'll follow you
eternally. It's to do with not feeling constrained and shut in and
so many notions, ideas, values, whether it's a dream, it's a state.
It's an eternal thing. Yeah? It's like the light shining out from the inside.
Is it really? So maybe it's all in the mind. Freedom.
So Blair shuts up.
A Greek?
Ladies and gentlemen, due to a technical maintenance, your plane has been delayed.
Dame I gospodo, zbog tehničkih problema, vaš let je odložen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very sorry to announce, but your plane has been cancelled.
Dame I gospodo, žao mi je što ovo moram da objavim. Vaš let je otkazan.
Ladies and gentlemen, in fact, we have no more planes.
Dame I gospodo, zapravo, mi više aviona I nemamo.
Ladies and gentlemen, all our planes are bombing and transporting prisoners, and we are winning! Hallelujah! It works! We blew the shit out of them. We blew the shit right back out there on us. And now their fucking ears. We did it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord for